Goodbye. Now I'm calling. Here, and the spectators down there, and I'm so glad that Dr. Angelou came up here so she could be part of this talent. God did give Dr. Angelou extraordinary talents, and as a result of this, her lifetime of achievement has made her, I think, a citizen of the world. But I'm here because I want to remind everybody that she is a daughter of New York State. And in a real spirit of bipartisanship, I am very honored and very humbled to be here to pay tribute for this truly electrifying evening and this very, very sweet and touching moment for me. So I would just like to, if I may, read a little bit of this citation from the governor of the state of New York. Whereas the Empire State is very proud to recognize individuals who have distinguished themselves through their lasting contributions to our cultural heritage and our society as a whole. Therefore, we join with Aaron Davis Hall in honoring Dr. Maya Angelou, a woman who was world-renowned as a poet, an educator, a historian, best-selling author, actress, playwright, civil rights activist, producer, and director. And whereas Dr. Angelou began her career in the arts as a dancer and an actress on stage and screen, reaching audiences across our nation and around the world, she also earned literary praise for her written works and has authored 11 best-selling books, including I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings and her current bestseller, Even the Stars Look Lonesome. And whereas in celebration of this communal, national, and global impact of her record of achievement and artistic excellence, it is fitting tonight to give her the recognition and support here in Aaron Davis Hall and to honor her with its Harlem Renaissance Award. Now, therefore, I'll skip the rest. We know who it's from. But I would like to confer this citation upon Dr. Maya Angelou, and I would also like to say thank you very much for accepting me here tonight.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, a special presentation from Dr. Danny Glover.
I had the good fortune of meeting Dr. Angelou when I was a young actor in Oakland, California, in the Oakland Ensemble Theater, more than a quarter century ago, trying to find my legs. I was performing one of her plays there. And I did nothing that would cause anybody to remember me, but certainly to be in her presence was extraordinary for me. I have here a proclamation from the office of the Manhattan Borough President, J.C. Virginia Fields. President of the Borough of Manhattan, do hereby commend and congratulate Dr. Maya Angelou for a life well lived in articulating her humane philosophy and viewpoint to the peoples of the world, and as an inspiration to all who have had the unique honor and pleasure to be in her company. And I had the unique honor and pleasure to be in your company here more than 25 years ago. Thank you.
Once again, please welcome Ms. Pat Cruz and Ms. Nancy Wilson.
Dr. Angelou, it is our great pleasure to present to you the Aaron Davis Hall Harlem Renaissance Award, made especially for us by Elizabeth Catherine.
I know.
Honoree from last year, it just is a greater pleasure. I don't think anyone knows how much I love you, other than me. I appreciate you. I will always remember your introduction when you introduced me to the symphony in North Carolina. All the good things, the everyday female things. Just, hey, how are you? Great song. This woman is a treasure.
That's not fair. Come on, sit down.
Thank you.
I think
what
I
want to
do is have a shot.
I'll see what the end is gonna be.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I mean, if this is it, it's right sweet. You see, men and women who I love and have loved for years, and who I admire and respect and have learned from for years, to see them here greeting me here at Aaron Davis Hall, to see Miss Cruz, who dreamed this dream, and her crew and her staff, to see Max Roach, I mean, see, you all didn't know Max Roach 45 years ago. Yeah. I mean, to see, to hear the excitement in Sonia Sanchez. My Lord, yeah, and to hear the music, the voices, Valerie Simpson, to hear the voice of Nancy Wilson, to hear that voice, that sweetness still in Gloria Lynn's mouth, to hear the beauty and the resonance of Dionne Warwick, to hear Sissy, you can see where it came, I mean, wait now, no, to hear that woman just stand here and sing, Sissy Houston, to hear the young men and women, I mean, to hear the South African baby child. It's in the of my heels. To me, I mean to go all the way. I came here to go all the way. And in case, just in case, this is my station, I'm supposed to get off here, it's perfectly all right. To say thank you, I thank you, Charlie Rangel, I thank you with my life. I thank my people with my life. I try to live a certain way, so you see me, hear me saying thank you all the time. African American and white American and Native American and Asian American, all. I mean to say thank you. Here's a little poem I would just use to say a particular thank you. It's called Weekend Glory. Some dicty folks don't know the facts. Posing and preening and putting on acts. Stretching their necks and straining their backs. They move into condos up over the ranks. Lend their souls to the local banks. Buy big cars they can't afford. Then ride around town acting bored. My job at the plant ain't the biggest bet, but I pay my bills and stay out of debt. And get my hair done for my own self's sake, so I don't have to pick and I don't have to rake. I take the church money out and then I head across town to my friend girl's house where we plan our round. We meet our men and go to a joint where the music is blues and to the point. Folks talk about me, they just can't see how I work all week at the factory, then get spruced up and laugh and dance and turn away from worry with a sassy glance. They accuse me of living from day to day. Who are they kidding? So are they. My life ain't heaven, but it sure ain't hell. I'm not on top, but I call it swell if I'm able to work and get paid right and have have the luck to be black on a Saturday night.
Without the generosity of sponsors, our board led by A.C. Hudgens, the ACADH Guild led by Ardrina Cook, and our exceptional production team led by Voza Rivers and Chuck Jackson. Chuck, again. And while time does not permit me to name all of the phenomenal staff, technical crew, and consultants who worked on this event, please know that they are the best in the arts. Yes. In addition to Lincoln Mercury, I want to say a word of deep gratitude to our supporting sponsor, Absolute Vodka, and Mr. Carl Horton, for hosting our reception and the party, yes, the party that follows tonight's performance. We acknowledge the generosity of our event chairs, Barry Gordy, A.C. Hudgens, Quincy Jones, Mrs. Coretta Stott King, Byron Lewis, Honorable Charles Rangel, and Delbert Spurlock of the Daily News. We offer a special word of thanks to the gala benefactors, Chase Manhattan Bank, Consolidated Edison, Mark and Susan Dalton, Rush Philanthropic Arts Foundation, and Time Warner Cable. And to American Airlines, the official airline of ADH, and
Yeah. Sister Houston, we've had an evening of superior talent.
Yes, yes.
Talent, right.
Has it been wonderful?
Oh, it's been, and, you know, exceptional.
We all wonderful.
Thank you.
So wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you. We love everything about it. We love Maya. We love all the people that, you know, this, you know, old school ain't bad at all.
Not
okay,
at all.
Y'all better join some
kids.
Hello. Right. So it was like really, really, really great tonight. We can thank Pat Cruz and Voza Rivers and all of the people that put this together along with Louise Merriweather. Here's Nick and Val and them. See, they're passing us right now. Y'all didn't get them? Get them. Right.
Thank you.
So, Sissy is here. Sissy Houston, the great Sissy Houston. I mean, but I've danced to your tunes. I've danced to everybody's tunes. And tonight, we see the legends. We see
wonderful.
Legends. It's just a
such
wonderful
a
evening.
Such
and it
a
was
pleasure.
A great honor to be a part of this program and to give honor to Maya Angelou.
Have both of you known her for a while? Or?
Yes, we've known her. So, you know. Y'all
gotta
look at some of the.
Thank you.
Oh, happy days.
Oh, happy days. It was great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So I was like, so, and I actually saw you in Lion King, so I was like, I know that girl. It was wonderful, wonderful. So
thank you.
Basically, if you could just tell us your name and what you thought of tonight's event.
My name is Sidi Leloka, and tonight was just one phenomenal evening with just a list of the most fantastic people, and I was just so inspired, and to be a part of this celebration is just so all-embracing from so many cultures and the different kinds of people who are here. It was really a special evening. You know, Dr. Angelou has, you know, it's just testimony to how many lives she has affected in so many different ways, the kind of different kinds of artists who were on the stage tonight just were a confirmation of that. So it was really fun too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
I'm working for Drum Television. We're covering tonight's event.
Okay.
And I just want to, you know, hear what you think and, you know, what you thought of everything that went on tonight as we honor Dr. Angelou.
Oh, dear.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, this was really my honor. I was saying to Dr. Angelou that I would probably rather have sung one of Aretha's songs in front of Aretha rather than have to recite something that Dr. Angelou wrote, especially my favorite work by her, which is On the Pulse of Morning, the inaugural poem, in front of her. So it just is just a magnificent gathering for a magnificent human being. And it's such a wonderful thing that is happening while she's alive and vital and able to receive it, and even so gracious enough to give us back some of her magic as she did tonight. Wouldn't you say, Kefra?
Absolutely. Maya is so loving and so giving. I mean, and it's great to have an evening where her friends and admirers give back to her.
Yeah, my husband and I, we spend as much time as we can with her. We love traveling to her home and just being with her anywhere in the world that we can be. I mean, she's more than a mentor and a guide to us. She's really our goddess, you know, very special human being.
Family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I guess it is about giving the flowers during life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Thank you. So thank you. Thank you for talking with
our
us.
Our pleasure.
Okay.
Okay.
You keep getting
it. Come on, ladies. You don't need that.
Hall is because of their children's programming, and they have been involved for many, many years, and tens of thousands of kids have come here, and now we have Impact working here, so it's the kids, it's the future. I don't really care personally about all these geriatric performances they have. I care about the young, new faces, new voices, because that's the future. I don't care about the past, I care about the future, and the kids are the future. That's all I got to say. I'm out of here. Thank you.
Can you tell me, was tonight's event successful?
It was incredibly successful. I've got so many marvelous and hardworking staff and producers that I've been working with, and they've brought in all these wonderful artists, and there were more than we had ever anticipated. And a part of it was because of their love of Maya Angelou, their love for the producers themselves, Chuck Jackson as the music producer, and their support of Aaron Davis Hall. So it was all that we had hoped for and more. And I think that she was very moved, and that is what means so much to us. So we were very pleased.
Can you tell us a little bit about the selection process?
The selection process, that's a hard thing. The selection process, the artists are almost self-selecting in that what happens is there are so few people who have achieved, in terms of their contributions to culture, the kinds of things that Harry Belafonte, Max Roach, Nancy Wilson, and Maya Angelou have achieved, that it's kind of easy, you know? So they've been so stellar and they've been so significant to the world and world culture that it makes it very easy for us to do. So we go through that and we talk about that, and that's how we've arrived at who was selected.
Okay. Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about some of your upcoming programming?
Yes, I'd be happy to. In fact, we have Bill T. Jones and his company will be here for two nights, and it'll be their only New York performance, and I'm very excited about that, and that's May 10th and May 11th. And Bill will be here in a conversation with the audience, which is what we do. And then in July, and we're doing a lot of programs between that, and then actually we're doing a free program on Saturday. We do that for our children's audiences, and that is incredible. And then finally, what we will be doing in July is a tribute to Louis Armstrong on his actual 100th birthday, and it'll be a free outdoor concert. So, and barbecue.
Excellent. Thank you
so,
for talking with us.
Thank you so much. Okay.
Are people gone?
We're here outside of Aaron Davis Hall in Harlem, where the incomparable Dr. Maya Angelou was honored tonight with a Harlem Renaissance Award.
I think that was pretty good. Was this too high?
The incomparable Dr. Maya Angelou was honored tonight with a Harlem Renaissance Award here at Aaron Davis Hall in Harlem, New York.
Today was another special day in Harlem. It's just spectacular. And what greater person to pay homage to the great Dr. Maya Angelou. I'm delighted that this program was brought at Aaron Davis Hall in the center of the village of Harlem. And I have it on good authority that Maya Angelou is moving back to Harlem, that she's about to purchase a home in Harlem. So, you know, this Harlem Renaissance is not just about academics, it's also about culture and cultural production.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, good seeing you.
Joseph.
Mm-hmm. What you thought of tonight's event, and then tell us a little bit about Impact, and then anyone that would like to say something, no. All right. Ted, you tell me when you're ready. Joseph or Josephs?
Joseph.
Joseph. No ask. Change up your name.
We're going to do a piece of heartbeat, too, as dedication to my...
Yeah. Oh, you're going to do a little something.
We'll do a little something for you.
Okay, we like that.
We'll do a little something.
All right, Mr. Joseph, so was tonight's event a success?
Tonight's event was an unqualified success in terms of honoring a living legend, Dr. Maya Angelou, and the outpouring of love in the form of talent energy, in the form of testimonial energy, in the form of political, social, and spiritual energy was just magnificent, and no less than this woman who's an icon and a light in our community deserves.
Excellent. Tell us a little bit about
Impact. Impact Repertory Theater is a creative arts and leadership training program. We meet right here at Aaron Davis Hall on Saturdays. It is a free program that is open to young people between the ages of 10 and 18. We teach music, dance, drama, martial arts, leadership training. And the work that you see the young people perform, the song they perform tonight, Long Walk to Freedom, and all of the dramatic material and the dance material and the music is written and co-written by the young people themselves as a reflection of their lives. They go into the community as agents of social change. So when we say to them, what is impact, they always say,
it's not a game.
What is impact?
It's not a game.
And the I stands for?
Inspiration.
The M stands for?
Motivation.
The P stands for?
Preparation.
The A stands for?
Activism.
The C stands for?
Commitment.
And the T stands for?
Teamwork.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for talking with us.
And a dedication to Maya Angelou, because she inspires us and she makes our heart beat. 5, 6, 7.
You make my heartbeat, you make my soul sing, you make my life worth living with the joy that you bring. You make my heartbeat, you make my soul sing, you make my life worth living with the joy that you bring.
Lord, I thank you for helping me make it through the good times and the bad. Lord, I want you to continue to bless me. With you, my heart is never sad.
You make my heartbeat, you make my soul sing, you make my life worth living with the joy that you bring. Heartbeat, you make my soul sing, you make my life worth living with the joy that you bring.
You make my
heartbeat.
Excellent. Thank you so much. And, how you got here? Because you won a contest?
Or? Yeah.
Okay. You tell me when, Ted.
I'm ready.
Okay, what's your name?
My name is Veronica Mills, and I was allowed to be here tonight to experience the glorious occasion by singing live on a radio station. I woke up one morning and I was turning the radio station. I came across something which stated Maya Angelou will be announced and dedicated songs and all, you know, the whole hoopla and everything. I said, oh, wow. Well, I must, hey, you know, I'll try this one. And I got the number, I called in, and the person asked me, do you want to sing? I said, sure, if that's what it takes, sure. No problem. I sang a song called, if I can just remember it. Oh boy, I'm just like at a loss right now. I'm just so excited to be here. I know.
It was a tremendous event.
Right, it was, it was. It was My Guy. You know, just a little chorus or whatever.
Can you give us a little something now?
Don't do that.
Just a little something, something. You watch. She is.
Okay. Let me sing. Okay, okay. It goes, My guy, my guy. And I can't, okay, if you talking about my guy, my guy. And then you went on to say, ooh. Okay, that's it.
Okay, well,
enough torture.
To
thank
us.
You so much for having me on
okay,
here.
Great.
Thank
good luck
you.
To you.
You too.
All right.
Read all right, come on, come on, come on.
Quite a question. It's overwhelming. It's wonderful. It's the best that can happen is when one's peers recognize a person. It is fine to be honored by everybody. It's a great blessing. But when my own people say thank you, everybody's my own people, understand? The Asians and the Spanish-speaking and the white and black and all. I feel that, those are my people. But when those with whom I've shared a history over hundreds and thousands of years say thanks to me, I don't know. It may get better than that, but I doubt it.
Bill McCleary, the journalist, says something very wonderful when we were talking the evening of the award, and he talked about giving people their flowers while they're alive. And this seems apropos to what you're talking
Absolutely.
About.
There have been some cases where people just meant to tell people before they, took off, when before they left this world. They really meant to send them some flowers. And the regret is terrifying because you can't remedy it. Mm-hmm. You can't undo history. So, and I think it felt good for a number of people. It certainly felt great to me. But also friends of mine had a chance to say something to me while I'm still mumbling around and stumbling around.
and able to say I thank you.
Mm-hmm. Is it wonderful to be back in Harlem, your old stomping ground?
It is. I've just buying a house in Harlem. Mm. So, absolutely. Harlem is where the heart is. And I've never left Harlem. I've been in Harlem in Tulsa, and in Harlem in North Carolina, Harlem in San Francisco. Harlem is a state of mind, and a state of grace.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Angelou, what do you feel is the significance of a cultural arts center like Aaron Davis Hall, because it brings you such a wide array of programming, like the choreographer Bill T. Jones or music by Louis Armstrong? So what do you feel is the significance of having a cultural center like this in Harlem?
It's wonderful to have a focus. It's always important, not just for a culture, but for a person to have a focus. Stabilizes. Well, with Aaron Davis, having the focus to say, right here is a center. Here you may see paintings. Here you may see modern dance or African dance. Here you may talk and be talked to by people who write books and poetry. Here, this allows people to, the neighborhood, and I don't mean just the neighborhood in Harlem, but the human neighborhood, to come and find a center, a place where all sorts of desires can be met. I feel that way about the Schomburg, too. I think that it's a wonderful thing to have in Harlem these centers where one can immerse oneself in one's own culture. Mm-hmm. I could just go on.
Dr. Angelou, at 73 years young, what is next for you?
Well, I'm directing a movie this year, another film. I hope to be doing a book written by Miss B.B. Moore Campbell called Singing in the Comeback Choir. So I'll probably use some of the people I used in my last film, Down in the Delta. That's one thing. I have a new book. At last, God, it's the sixth book in the autobiographical series, and it deals with Harlem, a lot about Harlem. It's the death of Malcolm X and the death of Martin King, and what happened in Harlem. And it's a vigorous attachment to life. I really will say something about Harlem, if you don't mind.
Please.
It is distressful that there are corridors of want and need and deprivation and drug addiction and abandonment of children. It's terrible. Under that, however, Harlem still has a vitality. So one would be stupid to give up on Harlem, just as it would have been stupid to give up on African Americans 100 years ago. It would have been just thick. We have the attacks of deprivation upon us. It's a part of the detritus of slavery. Slavery can't be wiped out in 150 years. It lasted too long, it was too deep. However, underneath that, there is a vitality. All you have to do is walk down the street in Harlem, and you sense that it's always rising. It's like the phoenix. It rises. And so it's fitting that I will have a house in Harlem and spend a few wonderful years in and around Harlem being revitalized, and even revitalizing somebody myself. So there'll be that, and the new book, the movie. I've made an arrangement with Hallmark, and my line comes out in January. And it's a line that I'm grateful for. I will be able to stand beside it and smile.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Talking with us.
Thank you, Ms. Finger.
I swear. Yeah, I was like, hey, that's our little tagline.
Okay, we're rolling.
It doesn't surprise me that something great always comes from uptown. Uptown is a state of mind, and I hope you stay in that state every time you get a chance.
I'll just take this out right now.
Thank you.